tuning in to the online broadcast network, AfterBuzz TV. Over 20 million weekly downloads in over 150 countries and your number one source for after-show entertainment. Johnson. TV, the destination for TV superfans, producing aftershows for over 300 of your favorite TV shows, interviewing celebrities and showrunners, and bringing you behind-the-scenes exclusives. All thanks to E! Entertainment's Maria Menounos, producer Kevin Undergaro, and internet leader Akamai. Now, let the buzz begin!
'Cause now I'm back, back, back.
That's right, I'm back today. Gone last week, and Christy, that Mazzari was
phenomenal. Oh, you watched us and all the way to the end.
I think you need a car, and you get a car, and he gets the car. I am Kaori Takee, and joining me is George Hermoza.
Hey, what's up? Hey, I don't know.
And of course, my Twitter right there, Kaori, and George's is right here. What's your Twitter?
Oh, it's at G Hermoza. The road to 300 followers is so close. I got 276 Twitter followers. Hopefully, you'll be the next one.
Yeah, and you'll want to follow George because SummerSlam is approaching, and he's got a fun little Twitter going on. And next to you, you got Paulina as well.
You can say something.
You can say something. Okay. Where can people follow you?
You guys can follow me on Twitter at underscore Paulina Aguilar.
And Periscope, too. You started Periscoping.
I did my first post today. Terrible. I don't know how to use it completely. I don't know how to use it yet, but I'm getting the hang of it. So check that out, too.
Yeah, good job. I was like, oh, yay, I'm one of her first Periscopes. Yay. And next to you.
And I kind of like this thing you were doing, so I'm going to do it too. My name is Christy Olson, and you guys can follow me at Christy Reports.
Oh, this music.
Yeah.
Fancy. Cool. And also, you guys can always go ahead and send us your comments and all stuff all week long at hashtag ABTV Total Divas. All right, guys, so we are here. We're going to talk about season 4, episode 7, No Holds Bar, but we are going to zoom through the recap because we have a special call-in, Brian Kendrick. And it's going to be awesome. Ooh. So stay tuned for that. We are so excited. And yeah, I mean, it fits perfectly because he was in this episode where Eva Marie decides that she wants to honor him with using his finisher.
Yeah, yes. The sliced bread. I don't know why they keep calling it the Kendrick, because the move is called the sliced bread number 2.
Right.
Why it's called that, by the way, I don't know. Maybe we can ask him today.
And she's renamed it to the sliced red number 2.
Yeah. Yes. Which is, I think that's pretty cool. A nice homage.
Kind of cheese, but I thought it was super cute. No. Red bread. All right. I get it.
For wrestlers to have finishers, do they come up with these moves? I mean, why not come up with your own? Or is she kind of just using it? Like, is that what wrestlers do?
A little bit of everything.
Do? Like,
honestly, there's so many.
Put a spin on it, or
yeah, there's so many finishing moves out there. So many wrestlers that, yeah, everything that you just said. A lot of times, that kind of goes into the play in designing a finishing move.
I also think it's quite common that when you get an apprentice, I guess I'm using sorcerer words, but when you get a student and the student improves and they finally decide to get a finisher, a lot of times they honor their trainer with using their moves. A lot of times, or it comes down through legacy. Like Natalya and her sharpshooter, stuff like that. So
she got it.
You learn something new every single week, Paulina.
Yes.
I know. I like it.
All right. So let's start off real quick with Naomi, aka Trinity, who happens to have stepchildren, and this is like the first time we really see her interact with them. And she's really wanting to spoil them and get on their good side, so she has a bounce house, a petting zoo, takes them go-karting. But they go so far as having fun that they tend to forget that there's some scholastics that, you know, the biological mom, Jessica, is not too happy with John for. What did you guys think of this whole thing?
I love the effort put in by Trinity, because I don't want to get too personal here, but I don't know if I ever would date somebody that has kids.
Oh, no way.
But if...
You can just say it, George. It's okay.
but if I ever did, honestly, one of the first things I would try to do is gain the trust, love, and respect and admiration of, the dad and the kids as well. Because if the kids don't like you, then there might be a problem.
Right.
So the fact that she's trying so hard, I think it is very admirable that she is, trying to get this bounce house and not trying to be a mom, not trying to replace her, the mom Jessica, but just... hey, I'm here and I love you guys too. This is my way of showing love as well.
And she also really respects the mother as well, mm-hmm. and their relationship with the mom as well as their past relationship with John, which I think is really admirable because I don't know if I can do it. You know, it's really tough. It's really tough have to have an ex in your life.
Have you ever dated anybody with kids?
I think that would be really hard for me. Uh-huh. Just imagining that the ex will always be in that person's life. Right. But it would take a certain situation. I wouldn't say no completely. Never say never. What do you guys think?
Well, they've been together for a long time, so the children must have been fairly young when Trinity started coming around. Mm-hmm. But what really struck me in all of this was that how excited she was.
Yeah.
She wanted to do this. She was so excited to be able to finally have time to spend with the kids. They've now moved to be near them. And so that's just kind of what stuck out to me. And it sort of ended up as like, no good deed goes unpunished. You know, like she had good intentions mm-hmm. and...
But she realized
She
realized what she was doing. I think she handled it.
But I think John brought up a good point too, where like, you know, let's say you have kids and then you found out your, you know, ex with their boyfriend or girlfriend is like, wait, you brought an alligator to the house? You know, it's like, obviously on paper it might sound a little too out there, but in reality we saw it was all harmless. You know, there was the proper handleage and things like that. But again,
handleage. I like it.
Handleage?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Handling, or apparently handleage because you like it. But yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, like you said, the intention was there and so pure and just was out of love. And to me, that kind of conquered everything else.
Yeah. Agreed. No, you guys already took all the words I was going to say.
Make up some new words then.
You guys said it perfectly. Well,
I just made up a word, apparently. You can put up some new words.
How about this, Paulina? Why don't you start by telling us what you thought about the whole Bella Twins action when we had Nikki and then Brie and then the mom and then JJ. They all wanted to do this bar fitness class studio. Yeah.
It's hard to do business with family. I've never been in that situation, but I do fight with my sisters like the way that they did. And you do snitch and you know, being an only child, that you've never experienced that. Mm. But I mean, I've snitched or thrown her under the bus and I was like, Nikki, no, she did not just do that. And you know, to Brie, to JJ, I've been there. But at the end of the day, you guys, they are family. And
yeah.
You know, I think they'll be fine if they really did decide to go into business with each other.
They could work it out.
I think they'll be just fine.
I would totally go into a studio that was owned by the Bella Twins for sure. That's mm-hmm. a huge name. I thought this was got a little dramatic and crazy. They were both Prana Moody at the nail salon. They both were kind of taking it out of, like, way too outlandish.
I thought it was hilarious.
Yeah.
I mean, I was on Nikki's side on that situation just because Brie kind of, like, was what? And kind of, like, attacked her a little bit.
She got crazy.
Yeah, but, I mean, I thought it was funny. I laughed at everything that they were just saying on each other.
I think at the nail salon itself, I was kind of siding with Nikki because mm-hmm. Brie didn't need to call her ADD and say she didn't understand her, basically calling her an idiot and not making any sense. But on the flip side, Nikki went and she did not make herself look better by going over to JJ and complaining and saying, I don't want to work with Brie anymore. This is what happened. She's like,
but then we see Brie do the same thing with JJ where she's like, oh, Nikki can't say it to my face, mm-hmm. but yet we didn't see Brie tell JJ that she didn't want him involved. So everyone did a little bit of everything.
Well, yeah, mm-hmm. we see this with this family a lot. It's like it escalates so quickly, mm-hmm. and it gets so heated, and then it breaks and everything's fine.
Yeah.
All the time. So we know ultimately everything's going to be fine, but this is kind of how they roll. Like, they get crazy, they get heated, and they go at each other.
I've seen the Bellas kind of get a little bit more heated in past episodes. I couldn't help but to think in this episode, it's going to be fine at the mm-hmm. end. You know, obviously, I think there was that one issue with, I think a season or two ago, where Brie talked to John Cena about, you know, hey, this and that intentions. I think that lasted like a few episodes. So mm-hmm. I was like, it's not as bad as that. So I know they're all going to prevail at the end. I like JJ. He seems like a cool guy. I saw him at Mania this past April in San Jose. I'm like, dude, I want to take a picture of the guy, but I was too scared. I want his hair. I like his hair. I'm trying to.
You should definitely ask, because I feel like he is trying to get a slice of this fame pie. I kind of have always felt like, not jealous, but he wants in on all of this too. And even the Bellas had a storyline where they brought their family members on WWE, and he was all up in that, all over it. Like,
oh, yeah, I remember that.
He wants to be Brother Bella for sure.
He had his junk all up on there not too long ago on Total Divas.
That's true.
Yeah.
And I don't know, just me. I don't know, when I see Mama Bella, I see like a wannabe Kris Jenner. Not that that's a great really? Thing or even a bad thing. I don't know. Just kind of always see her a
I
lot.
I get the total opposite vibe.
I see her in a lot more episodes nowadays. So she's obviously trying to put herself out there because obviously, you know, with reality shows, so it can be so overly dramatic and whatnot, right. But I don't know. She's pimping out her son now, so who knows, you know? I think if she had more kids, I think that'd be a good reality spinoff show on its own.
Who knows? Maybe that'll happen.
Maybe. Who knows?
I was thinking about this the other day, and I thought of, like, three titles just off the top of my head. Like, Being Bella. What was the other one? I was like, oh, well, that just needs to be a reality show now because there's so many catchy titles.
Yeah. I mean,
I'd watch it.
I would.
Right?
Yeah.
I like the Bella twins.
I do
you like the Bard and Bellas?
The what?
The Bard and Bellas.
Bard and...
Wow, somebody not a fan of Pitch
Bard
Perfect.
The Bard and Bellas. Wow. You like a lot of girly things. I respect that. I respect that so much. You got Tomboy just Paulina.
I don't care what anybody... I've never met a guy who did not like Pitch Perfect.
You know what's also cute is, in case you guys want to know, behind the scenes, George always brings cookies into the studio for us.
That's because
we
all...
Pink ones, yeah.
With sprinkles.
I try to charm y'all.
He knows.
By the way, were you watching New Japan Wrestling the other day?
Yes.
Oh my God, I love you.
Oh, that was the first time you ever said that to me. Breakthrough.
You said that to me last week.
Back to Paige and Foxy and Rosa Mendez, who were in the beginning of the episode for some reason.
Well, because they were trying to segue into them and their team hate on Eva Marie.
Which needs to stop. It's just, like, ridiculous. It's like, come on, I think it was Ariane who said you can't hate on someone's hustle. She's putting in work. Come
and
on.
Eva Marie, I kind of, in the beginning of the season, I kind of agreed with them a little bit. Kind of like, well, what happened in the last 2 years that now you started to get interest? But she did bring up a good point. Eva Marie said, well, how come you guys weren't talking smack the last 2 years? Why all this smack talking now that I start training? Mm-hmm. And it's like, dude, she's right.
She's right. Mm-hmm. She's right.
Absolutely. And why does everybody care?
Because they're incredibly threatened.
They could not be any
more threatened like, by her. And I mentioned this earlier on another episode where I was like, do they want her to have that kind of world-class coaching and training at the Performance Center? Not that Kendrick isn't world-class, obviously, but it's like, well, she should be training at Florida. Dude, let her do her own thing.
I think honestly, if she was training at Florida, they would still find a way to talk smack. And today's snippet with Alicia Fox, and I love Alicia Fox, but her just watching her videos and complaining about her training, why are you sitting there torturing yourself? If you can't stand watching her videos, why
don't
are
watch
you
them.
Watching mm-hmm. them?
Let's not obsess.
And any reaction is still a reaction. So, I mean, whether it's negative, yeah. She's still reacting to it.
It's like
she still cares.
Foxy doesn't have the easiest time letting things go.
I mean, I'm not going to lie, too, but we also have Rosa Mendez, who is not even really wrestling, really, and she's saying, oh, yeah, we're the ones that are going to have to take her. And
probably wrestling ever again.
I mean, she's pregnant now, so.
But she hadn't been, and she wasn't for a long time.
For a long, long time, and it just felt really just awkward and rough, and I guess this is a question we can ask Kendrick when he calls, but I do wonder how much of a difference of a curve that they're going to have to take as women when she finally goes into the ring with women, which she's been doing now.
Oh, yeah. That
because
is a great question.
They were making that a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just wondering,
well, and it sort of
really?
Made sense to me when they pointed that out. Like, oh, he's the one who's kind of doing all the heavy lifting and stuff. I thought, okay, I don't know that much about it, but that makes sense to me that could be the case.
Right.
So, yeah, let's definitely ask him about that.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, Eva Marie's been training, and obviously she's thinking about her finisher move, and then she also watches videos and watches a wrestler get his leg broken or snapped.
Yeah, I don't know how that got into the whole video, because initially she was trying to come up with a finishing move, mm-hmm. so she went to WWE.com and looked up, you know, they had a countdown of top 10 finishing moves. They showed Daniel Bryan and Justin Gabriel, who had a 450 splash, but then they showed this guy, for all your wrestling fans, in WCW 2001, this guy named Sid Vicious, who came off the middle rope and landed wrong and literally broke his leg in half.
Oh.
And if anybody saw it, as we all saw in the clip, it was not pretty to look at all. And
no.
I guess that was just a shower of, hey, bad. Just be careful. Don't do something too dangerous, because as you know, Jonathan was saying, I don't want your finishing move to be Eva dies. Because, you know, we've all seen mistakes and accidents happen in the ring.
Right, right. Well, and that was a good point because she is sort of getting, not getting caught up in all this, but she's giving it 100%. She's doing it day after day, and it's easy to get caught up in it and sort of get maybe a false sense of empowerment and being like, all right, you know what? She's improved so much and she's been trying so hard. I could see how she'd be like, I can do that. Yeah, let's do it.
I feel like her priorities has completely shifted from, you know, being the spokesperson model for Total Divas in season one, where she was vicious and not very likable, and she just turned 180, where a lot of people are starting, she's starting, you know, grow on everybody. So watching her at NXT, she was there, she wasn't doing a match, but she was being interviewed, and she got all these boos. How did you guys feel about watching that happen? Did it remind
you? I want to know what you thought first.
I think that sucked. Nobody likes to be booed. I mean, what she wanted was a reaction. She said it on the show. I mean, not the greatest reaction, but people are paying attention.
Yeah.
But you said it best right now, because that's why I want to know what you thought, because if anybody knows pro wrestling, is the worst reaction you can get in pro wrestling is...
a bad one.
No reaction.
No reaction.
That's so true. For you to come out and nobody just like, all right, let's go to the bathroom. You know, let me go to my phone. But the fact that she was getting a reaction, whether it's good or really bad.
People are watching.
People are watching.
It's true. So. We have a phone call. Let's pick it up.
Ooh, I wonder who that could be.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Brian. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thanks for having me.
Oh, thank you so much for calling. We're so excited to have you on the phone. Did you just get out of training?
I did, not too long ago. I run a night class on Tuesday, so still sweaty.
Oh. So we just watched the Total Diva show, and we saw you rock it there with Eva Marie. So how's it been training her? And how's it been?
It's been great. So she has an athletic background. She was a college soccer player, and I guess at a pretty high level. So she already came in with an athletic background, just not a whole lot of experience in training and wrestling.
Yeah.
But she has a knack for it. I think she's terrific. She's a dream student, and I'm really excited to watch her continue to grow as a wrestler.
How did this come about? How did you end up becoming her trainer? Did she kind of reach out to you, or did WWE kind of reach out to you?
Yeah, the WWE reached out to me. It was Mr. William Regal, who's the head of scouting talent, and he's in the office and well-respected, and a former trainer of mine. So he sent the message on to me. I guess Eva Marie asked Triple H, not for me specifically, but to get some training, and Triple H sent it to Regal. Regal sent it to me, and we were off and running.
That's awesome. That's cool. Well, you know, she was getting a lot of flack before this from the fans and from her fellow divas about her work ethic. They thought that she hadn't really put in the work before to try to train. What was your experience with her? And it looked like she was working really hard with you.
Yeah, my expectations, I didn't, you know, have any opinion on her either way, so I was expecting her to show up once or twice a week just because that's what the past has always been with people. But she's going in 5 days a week and would go in more if I had the energy, and would even do it on days she'd be flying out. She would find time early in the morning to come in and train. I've never had any student... you know, want to find time as much as she's incredible.
Great. Real quick, Brian, as far as the first day you met Eva Marie as opposed to now, what's the biggest difference that you've seen in her?
Confidence. She came in definitely just lacking confidence in wrestling because she had no experience in it, and the fans had been cruel to her in the past, and I understand why they had been, but her confidence had been shattered, and so seeing her then to now is that's the biggest difference, I would say.
As far as in-ring skills as well, I'm sure there's a huge night and day, you can say?
Oh, yeah. I mean, here's the truth. She never had the opportunity to go down to developmental. She moved down there, and they put her on the road. And so when she's in there wrestling, any of the matches you saw prior to her coming and training out here in L.A., she would be told that night what the move is. They would show her what the move is. She would learn it on the spot, and that's it. She had no training. She had no idea what was going on. And now she studies wrestling, and I think genuinely loves it.
Hmm. Brian, we were watching Total Divas, and they were saying, well, the divas that are kind of threatened by Eva Marie kind of were saying that she's training with Brian, who's a man, so when she gets into the ring with women, it's going to be a struggle for us. Do you really agree with that, and how much of a difference is that going to make?
So let me put it this way. If I were to say that, would I be sexist? And is this an inferior inferiority complex? You know, why wouldn't they be capable of doing this stuff? Why don't they believe in themselves and their ability to be able to do this stuff?
Nice.
Now, if you ask me, I'm going to say I'm better than each and every one of those women. but look, if you ask Paige will say she's better than me. You know, if you ask her, that should be her opinion, and this should be no problem for her.
Right, right. So how does it feel for you being on the show, Total Divas, pretty officially?
I'm not much of a TV guy, and my wife and I have an agreement when she watches Bad Girls Club or anything like that, or Total Divas in the past. I've had headphones on and I'm out of the room. So it's my first real experience with this type of reality TV. So it's very bizarre. Speaking of which,
I just finished reading Daniel Bryan's book, and in that, you know, when he first started training, a name that kept coming up when he first started training was Brian Kendrick. So considering that you two, you know, started with Shawn Michaels, fast forward, what, 17 years or so? And how does it feel knowing that now you both are kind of background players in Total Divas? Like, is that just surreal in some ways?
Holy smokes. I guess I'd never really wrap my head around that. Small world? I guess.
But also Cream rises to the
top,
really
too. That's bizarre, because there's no way he was... my guess is he has the same agreement with his wife. Like, there's no way he's going to want to be in the same room as Bad Girls Club or anything along those lines, right? So yeah, I'm sure it's a shock to him as well.
Yeah, like I said, just reading that book, I'm like, man, like, it just, when I was reading the book, I'm like, man, like, they're both Brian, you know, they're both, you know, kind of was considered small for their time, but look at them now, they're both kind of still there, they're still both relevant. I thought to me, I was like, now that's cool. No matter what anybody says, that's cool that they're both still there, and both in some ways still with Brian, you know, obviously having a huge influence on Brie Bella. You know, yourself having a huge influence on Eva Marie, and even one of my close personal friends, Daria Baronato, who actually is a host here on AfterBuzz, and now training with you, from what I hear.
No kidding. She's been a lot of fun to train. She's been going for, maybe a month now, but I'm real excited to see how she progresses as well.
Question, how did you feel about Eva Marie taking on your finisher and calling it Slice Red number 2?
I think it's great. I always called the finisher Slice Red number 2. Mm-hmm. It's just a tribute to television show Mr. Show. I think it's hilarious. I think it's great. I'm happy that she's doing it. She could try to come up with any other number of moves, and I'd be happy to teach her. But if she wants to do this, man, I'll take it. I'll take it, sure.
Yeah, for sure.
So she had her match a few weeks ago on NXT. What did you think of her match a few weeks ago?
I was happy with it. I know the one you're talking about. That was her very first match. She didn't even have any... what we call house show matches or live events. That was her very first match since coming out of training. So for me, I'm real happy with it. I thought she did great. She took her time in there. I'm real proud of her.
Brian, if you could pull any of the divas off the main roster and give them a little bit of training, who would it be?
I like that question.
Lillian Garcia counts?
Oh, yes! because we would love to see her in the ring. Good.
I would love to see her just drop kick people.
Yes.
So yeah, Lillian Garcia. Yeah, that'd be my choice. She's a wonderful person, and I would just get a kick out of seeing her arm drag and hit.
I like that idea.
Who would be like on the current roster? Who would be your dream opponent for a match?
Oh, Brian Danielson. Daniel Bryan.
Yeah.
We broke in together years ago, 99. So, yeah, I would love to. I don't know, you know, how he's gonna heal up, and you know, I'm 36 myself. I don't know how many, you know, bumps I have left. So I would love to have one last match with him. That would be the dream.
I think everyone would love to see that happen.
Yes.
Yeah. You actually had a match, I think, a few months ago back in NXT. Is there any more matches in NXT for you coming up anytime soon?
Oh, nobody's told me anything. I don't think there's any sort of plans that they're keeping secret from me, so I don't think there's any plans. I would love it. Mm-hmm. But as of right now, I'm just playing it all by ear.
Right. Oh, wow.
And real quick, you mentioned earlier too about William Regal. How does it feel for you knowing that such, you know, a highly respected man like such as William Regal, who's been, I mean, we all know his history, to call you up out of all people, Brian Kendrick, and say, hey, I trust you to kind of groom these people into, you know, and molding them into great wrestlers. How does it feel for you to be like that?
It's great, and it's bizarre because I have a long-standing relationship with him.
Mm-hmm.
So I still, you know, I call him sir. I always look up to him, but at the same time, we're friends.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a weird dynamic in that sense that if I were to stop and think about it, like that's they could ask anybody. There's a lot of great trainers out there, and in a sense, he's putting his name on the line by doing it. So I like that challenge because I want to make him proud too. So, but yeah, I guess honored. I guess is the right word. It sounds cheesy and stuff, but yeah, I'm delighted is the truth.
Hey Brian, what's been your favorite match so far in 2015 from all of the wrestling shows and pay-per-views and stuff?
It happened within the last year, but I'm not sure if it's 2015. It was actually from New Japan. It's Ishii versus Honma.
Okay.
That probably won't help. I doubt you're going to go YouTube it, but Ishii versus Honma is just really incredible if you like a different style of wrestling. That aside, I thought the match with Tyler Black and John Cena the other night on Raw, where Cena broke his nose, was really, really good.
Oh, that was crazy. Yeah.
Yeah, incredible match.
So on our panel, we have someone, Paulina, who is not necessarily a wrestling fan so much as a Total Divas fan.
Hi.
Okay.
Do you have any, you know, reason to tell her of why she should watch wrestling?
Yeah, because a lot of our viewers are actually in that boat, where they're Total Divas fans, but they're not hooked on the WWE yet. So what do you tell them?
Okay, so what I would do is just watch it without any sort of judgment of it being fake or being corny or cheesy or any of it, and look at it as it being an art form where these are live entertainers who are interacting with the crowd. Some stuff is going to be choreographed, some of it's going to be on the fly, interacting with this crowd. There's no second take for it. They've got to rile up emotions out of fans. Where these fans at WWE crowds are chanting yay or boo for somebody almost the whole time, and that doesn't happen at even a play isn't going to get that. You know, it's different than sports because it's not competition, it's cooperation. So aww. If you look at it as an art form, through that lens, you might respect it. Then you might not enjoy it, but hopefully you'll respect it then.
Nice point.
What do you think, Paulina?
I'm not going to lie. I did watch it last week, and I thought it was a little bit cheesy and all that stuff, and I did,
sure.
I'll be honest. I didn't grow up as a wrestling fan, so, you know, hearing from that perspective, I'm going to go into it
what, Thursday night, right? I believe it should
there's Monday, oh, there's Tuesday, Thursday, there's Wednesdays, there's Thursdays.
Right. So now I'm going to go in with that perspective, and hopefully, you know, I have respect for it in general. Mm-hmm. I want to understand it better.
That's good.
So I will definitely give that a shot with that perspective.
Yeah, that's a really good perspective even for me as a wrestling fan. I'm like, oh, that is why I watch it. That is what I like.
Brian, going back to your school for a little bit, I know you mentioned, and we all know you started with Shawn Michaels. Is there anything that you learned from his school that you implement into your school?
Yeah, I mean, again, this sounds cheesy, but that the cream always rises to the top. And it sounds stupid, but it's the truth. And out of the school when I trained back at Shawn Michaels, there was Brian Danielson and our friend Lance Cade, who's mm-hmm. passed away, who made it onto the WWE as well. And we really busted our tails. And Brian's bigger than me, but not a whole lot bigger. He's not a big guy. But it was a matter of just determination. And if you believe in yourself and keep working honestly and sincerely, that the success will come. And I try to pass that on to my students.
Cool. Why the Shawn Michaels School? I think you're from Virginia, am I correct?
I was born in Virginia, but I grew up in Washington State in the Shawn Michaels School because he was the best American. I think he's the greatest American wrestler.
I agree.
In the history of wrestling, I think he's fantastic, and the stars aligned that his school opened up, and I was looking for wrestling schools.
So kind of random question, but you're super into health and fitness, obviously. You're a trainer. So for someone like me who really wants to get motivated and stay healthy, are there any superfoods that you would recommend?
Oh, superfoods?
Yeah.
It's going to be eliminating foods. It's going to make a difference, right? It's going to be eliminating foods. Yeah, the greasy foods, you know, salty, sugary. It's not going to be any sort of, it's not going to be any sort of superfood. It's just going to be, and really, what's the point, right? That's what you got to figure out first, is what's the point? And if you have a goal, you'll do it. Otherwise, what's the point? You'll never do it.
Okay, so you're saying that, do you ever have any cheat days?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
No, I don't eat that good. I don't eat that good.
Every day's
a cheat
day.
I do a lot of training at my school, and, you know, it's all fake anyways. You know, it's all projection, so I imagine I'm fit, and so it is.
All right.
How long have you been thinking about, before you opened up a school, how long were you thinking about, you know, opening up a school?
Since before I ever went to Shawn's school. That was
really?
Is as I was winding down in wrestling, I wanted to open up a wrestling school.
Okay.
So, Brian, where can people find your school? Website and Twitter and all that stuff?
Oh, okay. I think BrianKendrick.net or BKSchoolOfPW.com. That'll both take to the same site. My wife runs a Twitter, same thing, BKSchoolOfPW, Twitter, Instagram, I think. I don't even know the passwords to put the stuff on. I'm not your target audience.
So. Oh, you are. Well, thank you so much for calling in, and you know you're more than welcome to come visit anytime. We would love to have you in the studio. I know you came in before for Monday Night Raw after show, so you're more than welcome for any other wrestling shows or Total Divas.
Yeah,
or
bring even, your wife along. We'll chat with her as well.
Or even tough enough, because I heard you're starting to train Mata now.
Yeah. Oh, man. I saw him go to lock up. He just went through the regular exercises, and then when I see him go to lock up, before he even locked up, his intensity, as soon as he did it, this guy just needs to be trained, and if I was running the company, this guy's a main eventer. Mm-hmm. He's just got this intensity. I think he is something special, yeah.
Wow, well, we're going to have him in studio with us in just a couple of minutes, so if you don't mind, we'll pass that praise along to him.
Yeah.
Well, don't tell him I said this stuff, because I don't want to inflate his head.
Okay. Your secret is safe with us.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, thank you again, Brian, and we hope to hear from you again, and maybe you'll see me at your studio.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you, Brian.
Have
bye-bye.
A good night. Bye.
Well,
that was cool.
That was awesome. We got some kind of juicy stuff from him.
So, Paulina, you're thinking you could see.
Are you going to think about joining his class?
You know, that's a good workout. I would not mind. I was about to say, I would not mind going to train just to see what it takes to, you know, at that caliber and all that stuff. So, heck yeah.
I heard it's pretty physical.
I need to get in shape. Get some nerds going and all that stuff.
Well, anyway, there's no superfoods that you can eat.
He's like, no, the expert foods. Himself.
Cut it all out.
You know what I was surprised about with the whole Eva Marie situation was that he said that she had no opportunity to train before.
Yeah.
For those 2 years that she was not in the ring. I didn't know that until this phone call. That's not expressed in the show and all that stuff.
Well, that's always been her story.
Right.
That's always been what she said for years, and she explained it, really broke it down with Kaori and I when she came and chatted with us. Mm-hmm. And to hear it from someone else who knows the situation and who knows how it is on the road, the girls were always getting at her, why isn't she, you know, at the events early trying to train her? Why doesn't she try to find someone else on the road who has time to train her? Like, come on.
And they might not even know that.
Yeah.
They probably don't even know.
I will say I did gain respect for her just for the fact that she was the one that called Triple H and said, hey, I want to wrestle. Mm-hmm. She's not being forced to wrestle. She's not like, oh, well, you've been here 2 years. No. She called Triple H and said, I want to wrestle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she told us about that. She said she approached him after her surgery last year and said, you know what? I want to take the time off if it's okay with you. I want to go away from TV and all of that and really take the time to learn how to do this.
I also think that it's kind of cool to watch her journey this season, because throughout the season everyone's already wrestling and in the ring, but we actually have someone who's kind of starting from scratch and watching her journey. So it's a new twist and something that, you know, Paulina could look at and be like, oh, this is what's going on.
Right, because that was their intention with having Eva Marie and JoJo in that first season. They had both just been signed to developmental, and I think that was what they were going to show,
but those ladies
got pulled onto the road because of Total Divas, and it didn't end up kind of materializing that way. So now, you know, four seasons in, it's finally happening.
Right. So it's a funny thing is we see a lot less drama on Eva's end, whereas we see more drama with the Bellas and even the girls that are trying to make something into something bigger than it really is. Do you guys have anything else to talk about this episode, No Holds Bar? Because
I just couldn't believe that with all the wine that Nikki Bella drinks, she couldn't open a bottle.
Yeah.
Not all of them are. I mean, that's happened to me before, where I'm spinning and then suddenly the cork falls inside. It's happened once out of, you know.
I don't know. There was a whole wine caper there that happened. And then Brie was, like, searching for the opener in her drawer. I'm like, you guys drink wine, like, all the time.
Yeah.
Maybe she
can
get rid of
those
twisty top ones.
Can I say real quick, though, when they said cardio bar, like, I don't know, it was B-A-R-R-E. I was like, oh, that's nice, you know, do some cardiovascular working out. And then, you know, maybe have a drink afterwards because it's a cardio bar. Not knowing that what an actual cardio bar was.
I thought that for, like, days when I realized that's what you thought. That's
hilarious. Sorry, I'm not so bright. You have to educate me sometimes.
So I have a question. Did the segment last week ever happen where we ended up getting wrestling names?
Nope.
No, I had explained to them that we cannot pick our own nicknames.
I
think nicknames have to be earned by the viewers. So you guys, or listeners. So you guys gotta tweet us, YouTube, comment on everything, give us some ideas of what our name should be. A couple people have thrown some out there, but nothing has stuck yet.
I think so. We should also add to, not only do we get a wrestling name, but we also should do our homework and pick a finisher that we would all like.
I like that idea. Okay.
Finisher and wrestling name. So let's move on to some news and gossip.
Oh, somebody gave you the Christy the Hollywood Reporter Olsen.
That's me. Well, we have a couple little things tonight. Paige gave an interview a couple days ago. Not a whole lot of juicy dirt, but she did say that she does watch herself on Total Divas. I'm always obsessed with knowing if these people really watch the shows or not. But what was funny about this is that she admitted to, so it's on Tuesday night, she's at Tough Enough, she records it at home on the DVR, and then goes home and watches it when she's home on her day off. So these girls aren't even getting a pre-copy of the episode in reality TV. A lot of times it's customary for the cast to get a copy of the episode that's going to air a week or two ahead of time. Apparently, they don't get that luxury. I suppose they wouldn't have time to watch it anyway. And a lot of people say that they don't like to watch themselves back on reality TV. We now know Paige is not one of those people, y'all.
She's watching
herself just like we're all watching her.
I mean, it takes guts. It's hard for me to watch myself. I'm like,
I'm with you on that.
Yeah.
And this was going to be like my big breaking news about Trinity and John, because they're their Domino's commercial role during Tough Enough, which aired before Total Divas, but it was on Total Divas 2. So if you are a DVRer and you fast-forwarded through, go back. It was about... Oh, it was right after it was the first commercial break, and there was the first commercial. John and Trinity were had this really cute little Domino spot. He was making pizza, she was ordering pizza.
He liked it, didn't you?
Yeah, we all sort of said, like, oh, that's their first acting try. Like, yay, good job. But like it was cute though, and we can relate to them, and
I think it's good. I think it was specifically because we know them, but I think from some people who don't watch Total Divas or wrestling, it wouldn't be that phenomenal. Not to be negative, Sally, but yes, it was fun. It was
negative
fun.
Sally.
Negative Nancy.
That girl was Kaori.
Excuse me.
And I know we talked a little bit about the ratings for the show in the first couple weeks. I have a little update. Last week's episode pulled a... No, I'm sorry. 2 weeks ago, episode had 1.176 million viewers, which was up from the week before, which had just over a million. So they're sitting pretty at a little over a million. It's still a few more people than are watching Tough Enough.
Okay.
They led in tonight to a brand new E-series called Wags, which you can find a former diva on. So, you know, if you don't get enough divas on reality TV on E! Already, then stay tuned in for Wags.
I also have a really quick news and gossip piece where in our first episode, the premiere, or was it the second episode? I'm not sure. When we, I think it was probably the second one. When we had that super fan who happened to have an eating disorder...
Mm-hmm. Yes, and she approached Paige in the street.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and how we were very skeptical, especially me. I was very skeptical. I just wanted to clarify to all our fans. I never said, "Oh, this is absolutely fake." It was bull.
No,
I just said I'm
that.
Very skeptical about it. But you know,
we were alluding to that it may have just been set up for the show. Of course, she's legitimate, but maybe having her there at that time, meeting Paige, that was just pre-planned.
Exactly. Because
what we were saying.
Yes, because it was unbelievable. I can't imagine something so wonderful happening. But something so wonderful did happen, and I got to speak with her via Twitter, and now we're Twitter friends. But she basically explained that she works there in that area district where they were shopping, and one of the security guards said, "Yo, you know, your idol's over there," and she freaked out, and that's kind of what happened. So it's real, and I am so grateful that thanks to Twitter, we can clarify that and let you guys know.
Okay, but in our defense, that never happens on reality TV.
Yes. In our defense.
And don't go around watching reality TV thinking everything is real, people.
Because it's not.
Come on now.
You never know.
This was the one time.
All right, guys. So let's talk about some predictions.
Yeah. And now, your AfterBuzz TV predictions.
That teaser for what coming up next on this season of Total Divas was crazy. I don't even care about that wine glass throwing in the face thing anymore. I am concerned. Dolph Ziggler. Now, I'm wondering how serious that is because he's talking... I can give you babies. I can give you
Is that Nikki's ex?
That's Nikki's ex-girlfriend.
Yeah, that one seems a little bit juicy because we see Nikki and John's relationship and they're pretty strong.
And I'm kind of curious. Yeah.
I want to know what led to that.
I'm always curious just how much of the wall they break because I heard them refer to him as Nick, which is his real name.
Right.
It's not like, you know, whenever they call Wade Barrett, you know, they don't call him by his real name and say, hey, it's Wade Barrett this, Wade Barrett that. So obviously you kind of think of it as like, well, they're not even using their real name, so it's probably just a storyline for the show, but the fact that they threw the Nick out there, I'm like, oh wow, maybe it's a little bit more real than
normal.
Well,
I'm pretty sure she also said, hey, Nick, last week when he walked by.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure if they did it, she called him Nick, not...
Well, oh, he Dolph was Ziggler.
Dolph, yeah.
Well, there's a
so
lot
that's
of...
probably what she still calls him is Nick.
Probably. If you're used, you wouldn't change it because you broke up.
I think Dolph is just a stupid name. Like some of them go
Ziggler
by their names,
name.
And you're not going to go by Dolph Ziggler.
But I did like that. I remember we saw a preview of it early on in the series or season. Mm-hmm. I'm like, man, I can't wait for that episode. And even like 2 episodes ago when you had them interact toward the end and you had Nikki kind of do, oh, well, you can't see me. But it's just so funny to me. It's like, just a month ago, Dolph Ziggler and John Cena were teaming up. And I'm like, man, that must have been weird.
Yeah. Yeah, but John is very, very mature. I think pretty, like, we've seen him handle difficult situations.
That's because the cameras are on.
I could totally see him saying, look, Nikki, if you want to be happy and he can give you that, I can honor that and
respect given
that.
Her that the door if she wanted it, and she said no. So I want to know what happened that led up to that, actually.
Me?
Well, I hate to tell y'all, my prediction is that Nikki Bella is not going to be leaving no John Cena.
No, I'm on that train, too.
She traded up.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, I love you, Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah.
You're cute, but...
Like, Dolph Ziggler is funny, though. He had a good line where Nikki was like, oh, so drinks on you? Like, oh, if I can take a drink off of you? I thought that was hilarious.
I'm sure we can expect many more of those cheese balls.
I hope so.
That's crazy that Paige is going to get married. Oh, gets married or engaged?
She's engaged. I don't know.
Some crazy
that wasn't
stuff.
As shocking as I think it was supposed to be. That's kind of how she rolls.
I think it's over. You know, it's overpowered by our interest in, my gosh, Dolph Ziggler is going to get in the way.
Oh, my God. Paige has been wearing that anchor tattoo on her finger for quite a while. Maybe she really did get married.
We'll find out.
I take it back, guys. Maybe she really did get married. Okay.
We'll find out. But in the meantime, where can people follow?
Everybody, tweet me and tell me if you think Paige really got married or not. I am on all platforms at Christy Reports, and please also check out ChristyReports.com. I appreciate it.
Woo woo! Yeah. And guys, I really want a nickname. I want to see how clever this can get. You guys can find me and tweet me at _PaulinaAguilar.
And you can follow me at Twitter as the road to 300 followers continues. At G Hermoza, that's GHERMOZA. You can just look at the right there, right there at G Hermoza. Please follow me.
Yes, and thank you guys for listening over on iTunes. And if you're doing that, stop over and give us a 5-star rating. Leave some comments over there because we love hearing from you. And also at YouTube, go ahead and rate, subscribe, comment, and press that like button right up there. And drop some comments and let us know what you think. And we want to thank Brian Kendrick at Mr. Brian Kendrick for giving us a phone call. He is training people at his school over here in Los Angeles, so get some more info on that website. And also, you can follow me at KAORIOUS. That's Kaorius on Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, all that good stuff. Twitch. Yes, Twitch. Twitch is like a video game streaming thing.
Oh.
Yeah. Also, hashtag ABTV, Total Divas. And thank you guys so much, and follow the AfterBuzz team at AfterBuzz TV. We'll catch you guys next week.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.